So hi, this is Kaustubh. So I guess the first ever slam is proof that ideas only need beer to replicate, right? One of the things I was really happy to find was that the tomatoes are really small there, so you're not going to be able to pelt me with anything large. The second thing I was disappointed was I haven't run into any San Francisco sourdough yet. And that's kind of what I want to talk about today. How many of you like San Francisco sourdough? And how many of you have had an imitation of San Francisco sourdough outside of San Francisco? And how badly does it suck?
Really bad.
Okay, I'm a baker. I have my own Urbana Champagne sourdough, and it tastes nothing like the San Francisco stuff. Okay? And what I'm going to talk about is, can we create synthetic ecosystems, okay, that can allow us to, for example, bioengineer San Francisco sourdough so that we can have a consistent product everywhere around the world? Would that be cool? Right? And so the basic idea is, can we create robust microbial ecosystems? Now, I'll stick up my slides here, and I'm just going to leave you with a couple of propositions. The first one is that natural ecosystems are far more robust and respond far more stably and dynamically to environmental changes. Nothing we do in biology today, in genetic engineering today, has that kind of robustness. Okay, what are those rules that we need to learn about from biology in order to bring them into synthetic biology so that we can create robust systems? And I've thrown up a few examples over there. I won't go through that because I'm going to try and stay under 3 minutes or 2 minutes. Thanks.